Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In the last video, we have seen how we can create EC2 instance on AWS. So in the today's video, we will see how we can install MySQL's latest version in EC2 machine. So let's connect to the EC2 instance we have created. Okay, so we are connected to the EC2 instance. Now we will check if the MySQL is already installed or not. So we can check the MySQL version. MySQL version. So as you can see, MySQL is not installed in the AWS EC2 machine. I am using the Ubuntu 22.04 LTS version. So to install the MySQL, so first we have to update the packages. To update the packages, we can use command sudo apt update. This will update the Ubuntu packages. So I will be using apt package repository to install the MySQL. So to install the MySQL, we can use command sudo apt install MySQL server. Press Y to continue. It will take some time. Press enter and press enter again. So MySQL is installed successfully. So we can check the version also. Sudo, or you can simply type MySQL -- version. So as you can see, we have installed 8.0.30 MySQL version. Let's use some MySQL commands. First, we will check the status of MySQL. So to check the status of MySQL, we can use command sudo service MySQL status. As you can see, MySQL is running successfully. So you can stop the MySQL by using stop command. Let's check the status again. Now you can see status is inactive. So to start the MySQL, we can use command start. And check status. As you can see, MySQL is running successfully. In the next step, we will see how we can configure the MySQL. So let's clear the console. To configure MySQL, we will use MySQL secure script. So this script will remove the anonymous users, remove all the test databases, and disallow the root user's remote login. Before executing the script, we have to change the authentication method for root user to the one which uses password for login. So let's change the authentication plugin for root user first. Login to MySQL shell. So you can type command sudo MySQL. First, I will show you the plugin which root user is using currently. So let's fetch the list of users. User, host, plugin from MySQL user. So as you can see, root user is using AuthSocket plugin. So we have to change this plugin to the one which uses password for login. So we can use caching SHA-2 password, or we can use MySQL the native password plugin. So let's change this plugin. So to change this plugin, we can use alter statement. Alter user name of user root and host local host identified with MySQL underscore native password by enter the password for root user pass at 123 semicolon press enter. So let's fetch the list of users to verify if the plugin is changed or not. So as you can see, the plugin has been changed. So exit from the MySQL prompt. Now we can execute the MySQL secure script. So let's execute sudo MySQL secure installation. Enter the root password. So would you like to set up validate password component? Press Y for yes. And this is for a password validation policy. You can select low, medium and strong. So I am using medium and enter. So estimated strength of this password 100. Change the password for root. Do you want to change the password for root? So you can press enter if you want to change the password, and no if you don't want to change the password. I am entering no. So remove anonymous user. Press Y for remove. Disallow root login remotely. Yes. And remove all test databases. Yes. Reload the privileges. Yes. So our MySQL database is secure now. We can use this database for our storage purposes. So in the next step, we will create a user. Clear the console. Let's create a user. So first login into MySQL shell. We can use command MySQL minus user username root minus p for password. Enter the password for root user. So to create a user, we can use create statement. So let's create a user. Create user username code Sagar then host name host local host identified by enter the password for this user. Say code Sagar at 123 semicolon press enter. So we can check the list of users. Select user host plugin from MySQL user. So as you can see, one user is created, code Sagar. and this is using caching SHA-2 password plugin. So this is the default plugin for MySQL. So let's assign privileges to this user. So I'm assigning full privileges to this user. So we can use statement grant all privileges on star dot star to username localhost with grant option. So this will assign all the privileges to the newly created user. Flush privileges to clear the memory. And quit. So let's try to log in with the new user. MySQL user code Sagar minus p or password. Enter the password code at 123. So I'm getting this error, access denied for user code Sagar using password yes. Let's try again. Maybe I have entered the wrong password. So let's use some statements. So first we will see the list of databases. Show databases. So as you can see, this is the default databases. So if you want, you can create a new database. So if you want to create database, you can use create database and name of the database. Now show the list of database. So as you can see, CodeSagar DB is created. So that's all for this video. So if you are getting any error while installing MySQL, so you can comment in the comment section. I will love to reply. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like this video. Thanks for watching this video.